Okay, all the time? It's time for some questions.
It's time for some questions. So we're going to jump right in. And, you know, remember, this is the fun part. You've had an opportunity all the entire morning to email, or the whole show to email Pat. Deborah writes in and she says, my husband yells and swears at me in front of our 9-year-old son. As my son gets older, how can I make sure that he doesn't mimic my husband's actions?
You can do it by leaving your husband. I mean, that's awful. He needs to have some really anger management. The idea that he would curse at his wife and say, you know, and yell at her in front of, I mean, it doesn't matter who it's in front of. That's outrageous behavior. We're supposed to live in harmony with one another. He needs Jesus. He needs to get set free. And you need to say to him, listen, I've had enough of this, and you are going to counseling or else. And you need to find somebody who is understanding and who can deal with a man of that temperament. You know, the Bible says have nothing to do with an angry man. I mean, you've got him. He's your husband. But my goodness, that's horrible. And insist. You say, look, I'm not going to stand for this. I'm not going to have my child brought up in that environment. And you are going to go to an anger management course or counselor or else. Okay, what's next?
That was good. All right.
You like that?
I did, except the first line, though, leave your husband, I thought, you know.
I changed.
Thank you. I'm glad you found Jesus halfway through, because at the very beginning, yeah. I was like, oh.
Well, I said, no, I better hadn't tell him to do that.
There you go.
My instant reaction
you
was,
found your way, Pat.
Yeah, leave off the key, Lee, get out the rack, Jack. Okay, go ahead.
All right, Eleanor says, a friend who was hypnotized to lose weight, a friend of mine was hypnotized to lose weight, and it worked. Is it wrong for a Christian to participate in hypnosis?
Yes, it really is, because hypnosis is you're giving control of your subconscious mind to somebody else, and you cannot understand what subconscious thoughts could be coming in. You can hypnotize somebody. It isn't hard to do. I know how to hypnotize somebody, but it's not something that should be done.
You know how to hypnotize people?
Yes.
What do you do? Get a little watch and say, you are sleepy, very sleepy.
You're getting sleepy. It's they accept that suggestion, then you go to the next. We used to do this in prep school. It was kind of a big joke, you know.
Yeah, I was about to say, do you go to, like, hypnotist school or something?
No.
I want to know.
We played as kids, like 16-year-old, 15-year-old, 14-year-old in prep school. But anyhow... No, don't get hypnotized. I don't agree with hypnotism because you're giving the subconscious of your mind over to somebody else. All right, what's next?
That's good.
All right.
I feel like getting a watch saying, Pat, you are getting sleepy.
Let's just,
all right. Yeah. Anyway, Mia says, I'm 18 years old and haven't seen my father in years. How can I initiate a relationship with him when my mom actually has no interest in helping me?
Well, you could try writing a letter, or you can try tracking him down. Where is he? And talk to him. The chances are... he might not want to see you, but you could give it a shot. You know, you love him, and you want to have some relationship. But, I mean, how do you do it? Well, pick up the phone. Yeah. That's how you do it. Or write a letter. Or send email. However you communicate with people, try it. And see if you've got to locate him first.
Mm-hmm. You know, Pat, that's a great answer, because I've seen this in my... just throughout the years of different family and friends that I've known, where, let's say, the couple breaks up or something happens with the spouses and the kids always end up hurt. Well, you know, I think it's wonderful for the kids to have that courage to say, you know, that might have been mom and dad's problem, but I'm not going to take what happened to them. I'm going to love my mom,
right.
love my dad.
It's got to be.
Yeah, you got to do that. All good, right. Good advice. All right, Tammy writes and says, I love Jesus, but I feel like I can never live up to his standards. How can I make sure that I'm good enough for him? That's a great question.
Tammy, I got news for you. No, you're not good enough for him.
None of us are good enough for him.
This man went to this counselor, and he says, you know, I've been told I have an inferiority complex. And the counselor talked to him, and he says, well, you know, I've got news for you. You are inferior. But
I'm going to make sure I never call you for a pep talk, Pat.
But in this case, you're not good enough.
Yeah.
None of us are good enough. We are in Christ. We are good enough. It's only through him. So it is surrendering ourselves to him and saying, Lord, I take your sacrifice, your spirit, and I ask you to fill me with your spirit. It is not by works of righteousness which we are done, but by his grace that saves us, not by what we've done. So don't try to do it. It's impossible. You can't do it. So if you surrender to him, he can do it. And then the blessing comes. It's by faith.
Good answer.
Okay, well, that's all the time we have for today. If she agrees, it must be something.
I must be good if I agree.
You must be good.